this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Photoshop to create a seamless Instagram carousel. You're going to learn how to take a single image and split it up so when you post it on Instagram as multiple images, it looks like a seamless image that people can swipe back and forth. And you'll learn some new techniques and tricks, including how to work with the Slice tool and Content Aware Scale. In this example, I'm going to give you 5 easy steps to create your seamless Instagram carousel. So here's our first example, this panorama. Our first step is to create a canvas the size of this panorama. It's going to hold all of our slices of the picture. So we need a new document. So we come up here to File, New, and up pops the New Document dialog. We're going to make this 1080 by 1080 because we want the square for Instagram. And I'm going to keep it 300 resolution, RGB color, 16-bit, and my background content will be white. And all you need to do is say create. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. So now you have to decide how many images you're going to put in your carousel. I'm going to say I want 3. So now that we have a square document that is good for Instagram, now we come up here to image, canvas size. And so now I need to increase my canvas size, and that is dependent on how many images I'm going to use. So I said I'm going to use 3 images. First, I'm going to change my pixels to percent. And right now it says 100. I'm also going to click on this anchor right here, the one on the center left, and I'll make sure relative is not checked. And canvas extension color background is white. And so I have 3 images. So I'm going to multiply the new document width, which is a percentage, times 3. So this is 300 now. I'm going to make this canvas size bigger so it's going to fit 3 square documents. So it's going to increase it by 3 document sizes. And say OK. And if I look at my image size now, it is 3240 by 1080. So that means we have enough room for 3 1080 by 1080 pictures. And we say OK. Now that we've increased our canvas size, the next step is we need to create the carousel layout. On our canvas, now we're going to need guides. These guides are going to separate our canvas into equal amounts of space where our pictures are going to go. So I'm going to come up here to View and say New Guide Layout. And the New Guide Layout is going to come up, and what you're going to need to make sure is that you have columns checked and clear existing guides. Now I know I need 3 columns because I'm going to use 3 photos. And all I have to do is say, okay, those are my guides. So now we're going to use something called the Slice tool. Slice tool is going to do as it says. It's going to slice this canvas up into 3 columns so that we have 3 individual columns for our 3 photos. So the Slice tool is under the same menu as the Crop tool. So if I left click, and I'm going to see the Slice tool. So if you don't see the Slice tool there, that probably means you didn't add it there, but that's okay. If you don't see it there, you can come down here to where you see these 3 dots on the left-hand side of the menu bar. Click on that, and up here at the top, Edit Toolbar. So the Slice tool is probably over here where it says Extra Tools. So what I did is I selected the Slice tool, I click and drag, and it's now under the Crop tool menu. Also, there's something called Slice Select tool, and I click and drag over to the toolbar. So this is the customized toolbar window. And I'll say done. And now I left click on the crop tool menu, and here is slice tool. Select the slice tool. So if I want, I can drag the slice like so and go to each one. But what's easier is come up here to slices from guides, click that button, and your slices are drawn already for you. Now if I come up here to the toolbar, left click on that, and where it says slice select tool, click on that. I just want to show you that if you want, you double click and you have slice options. You can name each slice a different name, and you have all these other options. And let's just use this name that it has. If I say okay, if I double click on the next slice, you can see that it gave it an 02 and the next one gave it an 03. So renamed them. Like I say, you can take those names or put in your own names. The reason those names are important is once you export your carousel, you're going to see that each of your images is named with a 1, 2, or 3 at the end of the file name to help you when you upload in order. So now we need to bring in our panorama image into our carousel, and we have to fit that panorama into our canvas size. So here is our panorama, and we're going to click on our move tool, or V for the move tool. Hold down your shift key, and by holding down the shift key, it should come in the center of your carousel layout. Our image that we just brought in is way too big for our carousel layout. That's okay. We're going to use the transform tool to scale it down so that we can get it into the boundaries of the canvas. So I'm going to hit Command T and 0. That way we see the handles on the transform tool. So with this maintain aspect ratio up here, this little chain, make sure that is off. Hold down your option and your shift. And what's going to happen here is it's going to scale right from the middle. So I'm holding that down and scaling it down as far as it can go. I'm going to leave it right there for right now and click the checkbox at the top to commit the changes. If I double click on the hand tool, it brings it up to scale and make this a little bit smaller. I want to show you something else. First of all, there's parts of this photo that still aren't showing, and we can use another Photoshop tool to help us get those ends of the photo back into view. So I'm going to come up here to Edit, Content Aware Scale, and from either side I'm going to bring in the handle. And there's a lot of photo that was actually not showing, so you can bring it in from the left side and the right side. So now we've got the extreme ends of the photo in view. Photoshop took care of squashing in the pixels in the middle where it needed to, and I'm going to commit the changes. And you can, if you need to, you can still use the move tool to move this around. I like it as it is already. And double click on the hand tool. There is our Instagram carousel. Now we're ready to export our carousel. Hey, if you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button. Now let's save our image out to the computer. So we'll come up here to File, Export, Save for Web Legacy. Here's what our carousel looks like now. You can see the three slices that we made. All we need to do is make sure that this says JPEG and very high. Everything else we can leave the same, and we can say save. And on our computer, we just choose where we want to save it. Down here at the bottom where it says slices, make sure it says all slices. Click save. And now on our file system, we have a folder called images. And this is what I was saying earlier, is it has saved three images, and it's got the file name with 010203. If I click on this, you can see that the file is 1080 by 1080. All of them are Instagram sized. And now I am going to airdrop these to my phone. And here they are on my phone. And now I could upload them to Instagram. So now I'm in my Instagram account, and I click on the multiple image icon. And I want to make sure that I got them in order. So that is 1, that is 2, and that is 3. And then click next. And this is my carousel, how it's going to look on Instagram. I say next. I can put in all my information and share it. I'm not going to share it right now, but that's how it would look. If you want to know more about Photoshop, click on this playlist here. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.